typical night in Whiterun. I don't know what it is, but something... I did good something, and now there's vampires all over the place. Everywhere. So some stage during the Dawnguard quest is when vampires just come at you from everywhere. I don't know what it was. I think coming back from the Soul Cairn with Serana and the other. Yeah, that's probably it. Coming back with the Elder Scroll that Valerica had triggers all these vampires coming after us now. It's the Blood Elder Scroll.
My boys will keep you safe. Don't you worry.
Mm-hmm.
I want to change your hair, but she's wearing a hat. I don't want to mess up people's inventories if they're wearing hats. So I'll have to mess with her hair later when she's not all covered up.
So, what would you like to do next? Of course.
So I found some hair that matches wet rain. I guess I'll call this the wet rain look that Vilya has. She often complains that the rain's gonna ruin her hair. Well, here we go. Now it's a thing.
Talk later.
Instead of her having those ponytail braids all the time, all day, every day, and her face is slightly different, she doesn't have the that girl next door look anymore. I was gonna try to make her look young, because her mom looks young. So now what I think what I'll do is if I ever bump into her mom, I'll just give her mom old hair. Done. I got plenty of hair for old ladies in my install now. So instead of making old people look younger, I just make old people older. It's easier to make people look older than younger.
Whoa! Look at the size of that mountain! I'm falling in love with this place already.
I like it here.
I think I ended up murdering everyone here. So I don't think I saved it. We had to try again. I was trying to pickpocket somebody. Or I think I accidentally took someone's mead or tankard, and that caused a whole ruckus. So I thought I'd come to Windhelm, take some pictures. I don't think I've taken any pictures of Windhelm with this ENB I'm using.
Did you know that Grunwald Freewinter is a veteran of the Great War? Many say that he's a hero, but
good
he doesn't
to see
seem
you.
To be very proud of this.
Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart. Up to no good, are we? I'll teach you, but it'll cost you.
Don't let my opinion.
Always a pleasure.
Why was Mickey with us? I guess I needed a healer. Mickey will heal everybody in the group. I don't remember if I had Vilya set up to heal us or if I told her not to heal us.
I'm telling you, I heard it. Howling. Those werewolf tales are true. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. Good speaking with you. Good to have you by my side, friend. I need reliable people around. Fair winds and calm seas.
He always says that. An old sailor's parting. So I'm still trying out some other mods that I've seen on Nexus. It just never ends. There's always mods for Skyrim. Always. Sometimes I hear someone on the internet say, "I'm bored. There's nothing to do in Skyrim." Well, I can see that they've modded their game. Maybe they just didn't know which mods were good for them. That's the thing. You can't rely on other people. Like, I'll say, "Oh, this is my favorite mod. This is the best mod ever." Yeah, that's subjective. It doesn't apply to anyone else. That's just each person's personal opinion. Like I've said before, no two Skyrims are the same after modding occurs. I try to give advice though, as far as, you know, maybe players should think first before they begin modding. You know, start thinking first about what kind of Skyrim they want to play. Like, what do they want to turn their Skyrim game into? A war game? A fantasy game?
Yes.
A survival game?
Safe travels.
A social game? A political game? Just
need a ride?
You against everyone game?
Climb and back and we'll be off.
Or you in a group dealing with other groups in the game? Are you a weapons person, a clothing person, an armor person? Do you like textures? Or do you like the lighting mods that are out there?
We should do this more often. Don't you think so? I'm thirsty.
Are you an animations person? Some people just like the modding body parts, you know.
I'm sure
replace all the body parts. Some people just like replacing textures of everything. Or high res, they make everything high res.
Sure. Anything in particular you have in mind? Yes? Do you want me to heal you? We're the children of Skyrim and we fight all our lives. Sure, but then you better keep the enemies away from me. Or am I supposed to keep us both healed and kill the enemies as well?
So I had Mickey healing us instead of Vilya.
Shall we continue?
I still need to find out why Mercurio has his active spell active all the time. I keep forgetting to ask. On the specialized followers, I think that's what he is. See if I can find my house in the dark. Some people like house mods. They want the big house mods. You know, the mansion size ones where you and all your followers can hang out. And it's got enough room to put everything you ever stole on a mannequin or in a chest or in a display case. Some people just want to be alchemists or magic users. So there's mods for that.
Honored to see you again, my Thane. Good luck out there.
I used to be guilty of this. Some people want to be like librarians and collect every book there is and have bookcases. You know, the bookcase modder.
What can I do for you? It's been an honor.
But, you know, I went on Amazon and I bought the Skyrim books. So I don't have to have the books now in the game.
Greetings, Yona.
When I have them in real life.
Yes?
Good idea.
So I quickly developed a habit where I just bump into somebody and then I change their hair on the fly to something else. I already know which NPCs in my game have been dying for a hair replacement therapy. Okay, so Vilya doesn't want to relax. Maybe it's... What's going on here?
Hi there.
Why isn't she turning it? Oh. I guess I have her... I don't remember what I had her doing.
What do you need, my Thane? Mm-hmm. I'll take my leave then.
Oh, she's still clapping about. What? At the tavern she was clapping and she was still trying to do that quest? Or was she clapping and then her magic pajamas appeared? Oh, I think I remember now. She wanted to hang out at the tavern and we left early. So she won't go to bed until midnight when that happens.
Good morning, okay. How are you today?
I forgot about that. Yeah, when she walks to a tavern on her own, you have to wait till midnight. You can't just walk out of there early. At least in my game.
Yes? Sure.
I think Mjoll is right about the Thieves Guild. How can people who would betray one another over a gold coin be considered as part of an association?
Anyway, so my plan still is to look for dudes on Nexus that I can install as companions. That, I don't know, look like dudes, I want to say. Instead of belonging to boy bands. I don't want guys that are in boy bands in my game. And I don't want guys that look like Chainsaw Massacre types either. It's gotta be something in between.
It's so nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, would you be interested if I told you a little about myself? Isn't it strange? For such a long time I have been homesick. I have longed to go back to Solstheim. I have longed for my friends and my family. Solstheim is cold and harsh, but Skyrim is even harsher. It's not only the climate and the nature, but also the people. I have been wanting to go home, but I felt obliged to first find the sanctuary, and I haven't been happy over the loss of my flute. Strangely, things have changed now. Since I met you, and no longer feel like a lonely and homesick outcast. You have made me see Skyrim with new eyes. I have started to appreciate the harsh beauty and the atmosphere of this country. To be honest, I am so glad that you are here with me, and I hope that our friendship will last for a very long time to come. Oh no. I should have expected this. I always understood you are a lone wolf. But I will really, really miss you. Remember though, that I will always be your friend. And that if you ever want a companion by your side, I'll be there for you. Talk later.
So this face I'm using for Velia has less expressions going on. It's less expressionary than Velia's default face. But it still does the job. I keep thinking, what famous person is her face based on? I want to say the girl from Mission to Mars, who was in Gladiator, who was Wonder Woman's mom. That actress. I keep thinking of that actress when I look at my new Velia face. Someone on Nyxus said that Velia doesn't talk to the Khajiits in the game.
Come and see what goods I offer.
So I thought I'd try in my game.
How are you doing?
I'm bumping into Velia already.
The wise trader finds the best opportunities.
Those two were talking to each other when we interrupted their conversation.
To find them. How may I serve you?
Tools, wares, and weapons, all for sale at fair prices.
I try to use mods that I just install and forget. I don't have to configure them, I don't have to tweak them, I don't have to make changes. They just run on their own, and they don't interfere with each other.
Put it to good use.
So I've got RDO running, and I've got Velia running, and both of those mods determine what the Khajiits will say. You know, it adds different lines to their dialogue, it modifies some of their lines that they say in their dialogues.
Khajiit will follow.
So many refuse to talk to us. Take a look.
So instead of saying something vanilla, they say something that RDO has them say instead. They'll still do the vanilla line, but they also have other choices of what to say instead. Also, I think I was messing around with the beast characters, the Khajiits and the Argonians.
May your road lead you to Warden Sands.
I don't remember what I was doing. It's something about... I guess
it's
the texture.
Good. Do you think it will rain?
And all can be yours.
I just have cover. Yeah, cover Khajiits I have installed. All that does is...
Yes?
It retextures the heads of the Khajiits.
Good.
Oh, and I also have the... I think it's called Digigrade, where I've messed with the ankles on the Khajiits.
Everything here looks so dirty and ugly.
So they don't stand up straight.
Everyone here is poor.
Like humans do.
Of course.
I guess the main thing right now is people asking, when will this mod get ported over to Special Edition? That seems to be the question of the decade still. When will this mod get ported to Special Edition? Those are the file sucks out there on the internet that want free stuff. They want it now. They're the ones who go to the hospitals and they want doctors to give them free surgeries. Or fix their cancer for free, you know, that kind of stuff. So you got the modders held hostage, the doctors held hostage. It forced into labor camps to work for free for both hypochondriacs and Skyrim players.
Over here.
And of course, if you don't port your mod over to Special Edition, then you're a Nazi. You're a Hitler. You know, thanks to millennials, that's how people talk now. That's the millennials' only contribution to society is that everyone else is Hitler. You gotta realize though that these are people, when they were born, their mom put them in the car seat and there was a sign on the back of the car that said baby on board. And that's how that kid grew up their whole life. Those kind of parents.
Did you hear that noise?
What were you saying?
I really like your outfit. It matches your eyes so well.
What? Which eye? Tell me. I got to know.
Anytime.
Let's go to the... did I record this? I don't remember. There's the bandits in the hideout over here.
What was that? Thought I heard something.
You can't win this!
Yeah, there's one guy there.
You're good. I wish I could use a sword.
Instead of two guys, it's one guy, whatever. I disabled one of the dudes. I don't see him around here. I didn't know what to do with him. He is immortal. He cannot be killed, so I just disabled him in my game.
Oh.
I was looking high and low on the interwebs. How do you kill an invulnerable person who's not tangible to the world anymore? Like, his weapon will connect to your face. But your weapons will not connect to his face. He has lost all of his solidities. He looks solid, but he's not. Anyway. So I thought I'd look at this guy's ID. If I looked at his ID, then I can remember what the ID is of the other person. So I selected the other person who's disabled, and then I enabled him. Brought him back into the game.
Uh-oh.
Where is he?
That's a bandit.
You're a creep.
Okay. This time it's a girl. See how their weapons go right through her?
Can't wait to count out your coin.
That's like the best power ever. No one can hurt her. So God mode doesn't work with NPCs.
You made a big mistake.
All the other things I thought of trying don't work on NPCs.
How brave you are.
So what I ended up doing was...
You think you can beat me? Go ahead!
I set her health attribute something below zero. That would kill her. Because the resetting the inventory, that didn't seem to matter.
You're a dangerous bastard, aren't you?
All these people on the internet say, why don't you just disable enable? Yeah, that doesn't work. It's never worked in my game, ever. When you disable somebody, all you're doing is putting them in suspended animation. That's all you're doing. To be enabled at some other time.
Come on, show me how brave you are.
Leave me alone.
You are as good as dead.
The white take you.
For some reason, when I reset the inventory...
That's the best you can do.
She's still using a weapon, even though she might not have that weapon anymore in her inventory.
You're as good as dead.
Come on, you guys, you want to join in? You know you want to. Yeah, let's make her go over closer. Because they'll follow her. Let's move her here.
Now I'm gonna.
It would help if.
You.
I did this right.
Never should have gone.
Okay.
Ha ha!
Just die!
You're a creep. You're as good as dead. You will be so dead. I'm not afraid of you.
Okay, so... She can punch everyone until they die. But no one can hurt her. Oh, here comes the troll.
You don't scare me.
If I raise my weapon, I think they'll all attack the troll. Okay. So she's beating up the troll. Anyway, we're friends with the Thalmor because I sided with the Imperial. So that's why we're all getting along rather nicely with this one bandit here. Okay, now it's time to reduce this person's health because I'm getting tired of it. And she's dead. Okay. So I'm crossing my fingers. When she gets respawned, I'm hoping she gets initialized properly and not be made invincible like she was.
Now that's how it's done.
Little help? What happened to your friend?
I am a Thalmor Dugisia on important business that you are interfering with.
I think the troll killed her. Yeah, she got killed by the troll. There was another body around here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Velia, get out of the way.
Yes?
I'm trying to roleplay here.
You know, sometimes it really irritates me that you are always deciding where we are going. I think it's my turn to lead the way for a change. Talk later.
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust. Was there anything else?